Thank you.
May I just invite Mohammed Jainal Abdin, another expert from Bangladesh, secretary at Dhaka Chamber of Commerce and Industry. He'll be just giving his view on Bangladesh SMEs. Are they ready for facing challenges post-COVID? I invite Mohammed Abdin to present his view.
Thank you very much for making the opportunity for me to share a few words in this August gallery.
Will you be coming late, sir? Will you be coming late? Should I call another panelist?
Hello, am I audible?
Hello.
Yes, now you are audible. Now you are audible.
Thank you very much. As the presenter already mentioned that my topic is SMEs of Bangladesh, are they ready to face post-COVID challenges? So I would like to go straight to my presentation. Before going to the SME sectors, I would like to have a brief introduction of Bangladesh economy. As you know, Bangladesh economy is contribution of different sectors to Bangladesh economy is, for example, industry 35.14%, agriculture 11.86%, and service sector. So basically, it is a service sector led economy.
Okay, excellent.
And if you would like to know the trend of Bangladesh economy, previously it was an agriculture dependent economy. Now it is shifting from agriculture dependent economy into an industrial economy. As you saw from 1971, that is from the liberation of Bangladesh till now, contribution of industry to the GDP is increasing. Service sector is also increasing straight, and contribution of agriculture to the GDP is reducing. It does not mean that contribution of agriculture to GDP is reducing does not mean that agriculture is producing less, but it is producing more while other sectors are going. Therefore, agriculture's contribution in this light, you can see the definition of SME. What is SME in different countries in the region? So I will straight go to the Bangladesh economy, Bangladesh definition. Bangladesh definition, it is defined from two aspects. One is replacement cost without the land and factory building, and another indicator is number of employed or workers. So if it is not exceeding 15, then we can say it is cottage and below 1 million Bangladeshi taka replacement cost. And while it is 1 to 7.5 million in manufacturing sector. So you saw this definition. It is very from micro, small, medium, and large industry. And this definition could be different in terms of different countries in experience. Now, contribution of SMEs into the Bangladesh economy. There are total 7.8 million economic entities in Bangladesh. 18% of those are cottage, 11% are SMEs, and contributing about 75% of non-agricultural employment and contribute to 25% of the national GDP. This 25% is contributed by only the manufacturing SMEs. If we can include the contribution of service sector GDP SMEs, then it could be even higher, because in this 25% only manufacturing sector SMEs are included. So contribution is 25%, and it is contributing about 75 to 80% of Bangladesh export earnings. So contribution of SMEs to the GDP is very promising. Obviously, we have target to increase this 20% into 32% in this budget we had the target. So now come to the point, industrial sectors. What are the sectors representing SMEs? So I would mention agro-processing sector, ready-made garment sector, pharmaceutical, leather, light engineering, jute products, these types of sectors. Bangladesh is trying to diversify its export basket. As a result, we are trying to enlarge the list of sectors as many as we can. So this sectors list, you are seeing, there are 11 sectors have more promising performance than the others. These sectors are called SME booster sectors. So these sectors are electronic, software development, light engineering, agro-processing, leather, knitwear, synthetic, ready-made garments, healthcare, educational services, and cosmetics, toiletries, and aesthetics products, these sectors. Also in industrial policy 2010, we had identified 32 thrust sectors, those having potential to grow further, and 7 high priority sectors. Now we have 33 sectors in our latest industrial policy, that is 2016. Now come to the point, what impact COVID-19 will have on global economy. As we know that ILO predicted that one of every 6 employee will lose their jobs due to this pandemic. UNCTAD has predicted that FDI will shrink 40% in the current and next year due to this pandemic. And global poverty, King's College London has forecasted global poverty could rise above 1 billion. ADB has some forecasting, and more importantly, WTO forecasted that global trade, international trade, will reduce into 13 to 30% due to this pandemic. So now come to the point, what Bangladesh economy will face. Obviously, Bangladesh economy will face a very tremendous challenge due to this COVID-19 situation. World Bank has predicted that Bangladesh economic growth will be weakened further 1.6% due to this pandemic. IMF forecasted that Bangladesh economy will grow only 8%. You know, during last couple of decades, Bangladesh economy raised 7% and even higher per year, but on due to this pandemic, the economy will shrink into only 3.8%. As per Bangladesh Ready-Made Garments Manufacturers and Exporters Association, we already lose $3 billion work order since inception of this COVID. I mean, last couple of months, we have lost $3 billion work order. Another organization and forecasted that 1.3 crore people in the country, particularly part-time temporary workers, are at risk of losing employment. Our export has shrunk into 18%, and remittance reduced into 14%. And finally, the poverty rate may be doubled. During last couple of decades, we have reduced our poverty rate up to 23%. Now, our statistics forecasted it that the poverty rate will increase up to 40.9% due to this COVID pandemic. So it will have a very negative impact on Bangladesh GDP. So what challenges SMEs are facing due to this COVID-19 situation? The first and foremost challenge is lockdown. Lockdown has stopped product delivery and raw material supply. So at first hit, COVID had on small and medium enterprises, the COVID situation stopped their supply and supply and delivery system. Then supply chain disrupted. As supply chain has been disrupted, then you will see two situations. Number one is after production, while our dispatch or storage is overloaded because we cannot deliver to the buyer houses or retailers or wholesalers. But at the same time, we are facing tremendous cases of raw materials. So our raw materials is shortage now. Then factory closed, because while complete shutdown is there, so factory has to be closed. So off production is off. When production is off for 3 or 4 months, how salary will be paid? So that is another question. So as per a recent study, Bangladesh is losing 33 billion Bangladeshi taka per day. So for last 3 or 4 months, we can count it that Bangladesh lost $3 trillion, 3 trillion Bangladeshi taka. That is about 13% of our GDP due to this pandemic crisis. Shortage of cash flow. So from functional point of view, SMEs will face another tremendous challenge that their accounts receivable are is stuck on the buyer's pocket, and as a result they are unable to pay the account payables to the suppliers. So working capital shortage is there. Finally, rise of account receivable and payable, and money gets stuck, and business become vulnerable, and sick industry. So sick industry needs stimulus packages or bailout packages. So thus most of the SMEs, small and medium enterprises, are becoming sick due to this COVID situation, due to this pandemic. Now come to the point, what government is also thinking about the situation. Therefore, in current fiscal budget, Bangladesh government has offered taka 50 billion taka to pay salaries to the workers, and taka 200 billion stimulus packages for the quotas, micro and small and medium enterprises. And Bangladesh government has reduced its interest rate from 9% to 4.5%. As my previous presenter, Mr. S.M. Zilur Rahman, has already mentioned it. Bangladesh government is also formed a refinancing scheme of taka 100 billion to make quotas, micro and small and medium enterprises packages. And it is also offering taka 50 billion pre-shipment refinancing credit fund for at 6% interest rate to make the SMEs competitive. So SME, the COVID-19 situation hit the SMEs, and especially MSMEs tremendously. They are becoming working capital shortage. They are becoming idle. They are becoming sick. So government is also trying to offer stimulus packages, bailout packages, to rescue the SMEs from this COVID situation. So what is the way forward? If we would like to give some short notes, then the word for it could be strategic planning, considering health and security as a priority. Before COVID situation, the small and medium enterprise owners never thought about the health security of workers or health security of their professionals. But nowadays, it should be planned, pre-planned, how the workers' health security and safety will be managed. In second option, we can say that plan an alternative mode of communication, because while you are unable to pay your suppliers, then your supplier will stop supplying raw materials. While you are unable to pay your workers, then workers will stop working. While you will be unable to pay other receivers, then stakeholders, then everybody will have a reaction. So in this situation, you have to plan your alternative mode of communication, how you will communicate your inability, your plan about what you are, would like to do, how you would like to pay, when you would like to pay. These types of communication needed with suppliers, with workers, as well as with your buyers. So effective dealing with the cash flow. Obviously, due to pandemic, sales reduced. As sales is reduced, so everything, your cash inflow is reduced. So while cash inflow is reducing, but you have to pay the utility bill, pay the workers' salaries and wages, you have to pay the others' fixed costs. So your cash flow will be limited. So please plan your cash flow accordingly. Take care of your suppliers. In this point, I would say, obviously, you have to sit with your suppliers, negotiate or consult with suppliers how you can manage your business during this pandemic. Finally, adopt new health and safety practices. Obviously, there are some sectors needs healthcare facilities, especially during this COVID-19 pandemic. So you have to adopt healthcare facilities and healthcare system in your factories and in your company. Newly, which was not required before the COVID-19 pandemic. So ensure adequate rolling of cash flow per week. You have to plan. Previously, you plan per year, you plan per month, but due to this COVID-19 situation, your per month or per year decision may not be applied. So plan per week how much money you need for collecting raw materials, how many products you will produce, how you will supply to the market, and when you will you get the cash inflow, and how you will pay. So you have to plan adequately to roll out the cash flow per week. Prepare for the post-crisis recovery. The most important thing for the SMEs to survive from this hard hit of coronavirus is the post-crisis recovery period, because you are running somehow, because you have conducted 3 or 10 years business before. So you are running from your savings, your previous savings, and your bank liquidity. But after the crisis, you will face another crisis from everything. So plan accordingly how you will overcome that post-crisis and you will recover your business. So finally, property utilization digital platform. In every business, there could be an option of digital operation. For example, nowadays, our e-commerce site, e-business site are doing better. So most of the SMEs can transform their business from ordinary mode of operation to the digital mode of operation. So please plan accordingly how your digital wing, how your digital operational department can support your sales, your marketing, your promotion, everything. So proper utilization of digital modes and obviously from the functional point of view, the board meetings and other could be organized in digital format. So please go digital to save you from the heat heart of COVID-19. So that was all from my side, and thank you very much for inviting me in this August gathering. Thank you.
Thank you, Mohammad Abdin, for sharing valuable statistics that will benefit the Bangladeshi SMEs over there. And you are already doing so many things for the past for support of Bangladesh SMEs over here. Mr. Rahman and you, you can better support them so that they can come out from this COVID-19 challenges. Now, next expert is Dr. Shankar Goenka.